Gotcha. Yeah. Mike on in the building. But the mother of this shit. To Panther TV. Today I'm here with an distinguished guest, a concerned citizen, and they're here to talk about the impediment of Africa due to religion. So I'm going to let them introduce themselves. Can you guys go ahead and introduce yourself?
My name is Melfleck.
Melfleck.
My name is Go.
Go. Welcome to Panther TV, and today as we are here, I just want you guys to give us more lighting about what you guys saying that the reason why Africa is underdeveloped due to religion. I want you guys to throw some light on it. I'll start with you first. I want you to give me more emphasis on that. What do you think?
Yes, I'm very, very grateful for this platform. I see a lot of posts online. I see a lot of pastors. I see a lot of people saying things online about religion, about the way they use it to fool our people. First of all, we need to understand where this religion came from. We need to understand how it all started. How the ancient Romans, the ancient Babylonians, used religion to capture the mind of their people, where the elites used religion to subdue their subjects. So because of this, they actually brought this experiment and used it in Africa. If you check your Bible, they will tell you, slaves, obey your master. Who are you to tell me I'm a slave? And who are you to tell me you're the master? So if we are to follow the beginning of the process, religion has even done more harm in the developed countries before they were able to open their eyes. So I think it's high time for us in Africa to open our eyes also, so that we can be able to move forward from this. Thank you.
Wow, what an amazing content. I really understand what you're saying. So I'm going to ask my brother to throw more light on what you just said for all not even listeners or people that are watching to be able to understand what you're saying.
All right, thanks. So I talk of religion, why religion is impeding progress in Africa. I think with the church, okay? Let's say the church. So the reason why religion is impeding progress is that if you, for instance, let's take the Christianity, like it's so many religions. So let me say Christianity. If you take Christianity, you will see that anything the pastor says in the name of God, the congregation should do or bring, they do that without thinking, okay? But if you tell them to find work hard, they don't think that is the way. They think God in the sky somewhere they will pray to will bless them and give them what they want.
Okay, so for me to throw more light on this, let me ask you a question. How would worshiping something being the underdevelopment of an African or for Africa, like somebody just going to church, how is that going to imply for Africa not to be developed?
Because they think a God in the sky, like I was saying, will bless them and give them what they want. Or in this world, we don't take this world for nothing. Let's go to somewhere called heaven. That is where a father or someone prepared for us to like have eternal life. So with this world, we are not taking it anywhere. That is how Africa is shit.
Okay, so I'll go down to my brother here. So you actually, I want to ask you this question. You came from African background, right?
Yes.
And you were taught to be worshiping. If I may ask, which religion are you from?
I grew up with a Catholic family.
Okay.
My dad would beat us every morning. He would tell you, because you need to go to morning mass, you need to go for Easter, you need to say the morning devotion. I could say everything. I was baptized, I think I went around 11. I did my confirmation, I had my Eucharist, I had everything. But I would tell you this is bullshit.
So when did you open your eyes, or when did you start realizing that this is what you just said it is?
When I was growing up as a kid, I really wanted to be a Reverend Father. I'm telling you the truth, fact. I really wanted to be a Reverend Father. I would see those priests on the altar giving us the Holy Communion, so you feel so holy. But as I got wiser and I begin to use my sense of reasoning, I don't believe in the supernatural realm, even though I love the African religion so much. I love the African religion so much because it's a culture. But I don't believe in the supernatural realm.
So I began to wonder this. There was one time I was in school. I was in school then. That was 2007. So there was this student pastors in school. So they were praying, you need to speak in tongues. So they said, today we need to speak in tongues. And truly, bro, I really want to speak in tongues. I want to have that experience. My heart and my intentions were genuine, very, very genuine. So the guy whispered into my ear. And he said, no, I'll tell you the exact word. He said, Sindere, Skibo. I'll never forget that word. So I was laughing. So when I got to my, I began to realize, I was like, everything is just lies upon lies. So I started to study the Bible as someone that is reading. I want to understand. Then I go to Europe, the foundation of Christianity. And I discovered that even they don't even believe in this person. Remember that day we were talking to somebody in the taxi? Mm-hmm. We asked him, why are you a Christian? What did he say?
He said because he was born to the religion. He doesn't understand why he should go to church.
I'm not talking about how religion really is really affecting African
people. Yeah, definitely. That was what I wanted to
ask. Let me get to that. You see, religion has done good. It has done bad. But if we look at the context of how religion came to Africa, I'm not going to talk about just Christianity, but even the Muslim religion, even the traditionalist. Let's take it this way. When the white man came, what did they give us first? Religion. They gave you religion to subdue you. They gave you Christianity to subdue you. I'm not sorry. Even if you check the Muslim religion, it's all about submission. I would ask you one question today, my listeners, because I know from here I want to talk to people. You have a free will. According to the Bible, well, I've studied the Bible very well. You have a free will. Somebody said he gave you a free will, bro. This that I give it to you. Okay? It's yours. I'm giving it to you. You should do whatever you want to do with it. I'm not to question you what you did with it. It's yours. So how will you give me a free will? And you tell that's I'm going back to their Bible. How will you give me a free will? And tell me, don't do whatever you want to do with it. And there's a question in that religion in the first place.
So okay, that was actually a very good scenario according to my own understanding. Mm-hmm. You actually get the light that Africa, the best way for you to live your life is a free will given to us by God. Mm-hmm. We believe there is a God, right?
No, I don't, that's the problem. If I am an African man in the African setting. So if you ask me in an African way, are you with me?
Yes.
That if you have to ask African way that, do you serve anything? I will tell you yes. I'm a traditionalist to the core. Because that was what I met my ancestors doing. I would not leave my God to serve another thing. No, you brought yours to my land. You told me yours is superior to mine. My ancestors accepted it and see where they are today.
I like the fact that you're sending us back to olden days or back to our generation, our fathers, which is a very good thing. But let me ask my brother here. Brother, tell us, what basically do you think is the reason for Africa not, like you said, impediment of religion of Africa? I don't understand.
Religion is impeding progress in
Africa. Okay.
The whole thing in the summarization is that in Africa, we believe in the God in the sky rather than hard work pays. The God in the sky will pay us, not hard work. Okay? That is the summarization. That is why we are still poor, hoping that the God in the sky will come and bless us. So you will see that most
sorry to cut you short. They believe in the story of the manna that fell from heaven.
Exactly.
That God will save from heaven.
Exactly.
An African man would destroy trees to build churches.
Exactly.
But he would not use that. He would not use that church to.
Let me give you a good scenario. In Europe right now, they are making away with churches and building like nightclub factories. And in Ghana, for instance, where I come from, they are destroying houses and building the churches. And we are going to these churches to pray for the jobs we have destroyed.
In my country,
it's logically,
You see, we are
They destroyed factories.
But they turned into churches.
The good thing is that, like, we are waking up in Africa. For instance, Paul Kagame, rather destroying the churches. He's closing down some churches, which are really aimless. Yeah. We are waking up, and that is a good sign.
Bro, this morning when I woke up, I'm always on Instagram. So when I woke up, I saw the post I showed you this morning about my brothers in Malawi or so worshipping the goats. Are you kidding me?
No, maybe that was a way for them to go back.
No, bro, that is not a way. That is foolishness.
I think Africa, we are very religious.
Why would you go and walk rather than praying to somebody over there to come and feed you, bro? This is your place. This is your place. This is where you belong.
Okay. So it is actually a very good topic. So as an individual, right? Since you already said your eyes are open or your eyes are clear from you believing in Catholic, and now you want to change the fact that what you are believing in is totally different of what you're saying. So what is your advice to somebody that is watching you right now?
Okay, first of all, I'm not saying my eyes is open.
Okay.
I have my own point of view.
Okay.
You are free to do whatever you want to do. I'm only saying this from my own point of view because I've seen the atrocities that Nigerian pastors have committed. Not just Nigerian pastors, American pastors. You've given us lies upon lies upon lies, telling people to use their hard-earned money to pay for tithes. And you have like 3 private jets, 6 private jets. And how are we going to develop as a country when the president of my country is going to kneel? I'm saying this. Going to kneel for pastors to pray for him to win an election. No, bro. If you do well, you don't need any divine power to give you any authority. If you do well for your people, you will win the election. I'm sorry, President Jonathan, man. I'm about to tell you the truth.
Okay, that's a very good topic. So, brother, what you have to throw on light for somebody that is watching us right now and they might be having same skepticality, but due to the fact that he's under some spell or maybe the place where he is, he cannot just say it out. What would you advise the person to do? What ways that...
Well, for me, I believe that ever since we have been taught, I was also brought up in a Christian home. My father was a Catholic, my mother was a Catholic, so... Basically, I'll say I'm Catholic, but I'm not religious, that's it. So, we realized that we were taught about a religion or a God whose supernatural powers can only be seen in the book, okay? Like all the miracles he did can only be seen in the book. And we were taught that this happened some very long time ago. Nobody was there can confirm it to us. So, with me, my humble opinion, well, is... that you should rather see the God inside you rather than waiting for something to happen or some miracle or some manna to fall from the sky. You should rather go deep inside yourself. I think that is where you find God.
So final message to Africans, to Africa, because this was the message to African. Now the final message to African, Africa, the whole continent.
Africa as a continent.
Yeah.
Well, my message to Africa as a continent is that we should wake up because the religion is really killing us. It's really killing us. They should just... Because one thing is the proof that I can give is that the religion, as I said, the supernatural powers and the miracles that God did that convinced the people to go or worship him can only be seen in the book. We don't see any Jesus now or any pastor walking on top of water or healing the blind. They do it in the churches. They don't go to the hospitals where the real sick people are. You see? So they are rather taking the tithe, offering from the people. So it's really killing us. So we should wake up and then really address that.
So my brother, do you have anything to say regarding what we just said?
An African, if you are age mate, if you're younger than me, if you're older than me, the first thing to do as an African is, first of all, you have to be an African. Forget about Jesus. Forget about
No, you cannot.
These are my own followers. These are people that want to listen to me.
Okay.
I have my own point of view.
Okay.
Yeah, I like him because of that. Because his point of view is actually...
My point of view.
Yeah, so...
What I feel should make my country forward. My generation. My continent forward. Mm-hmm. If you go to India, they are not Christian. They are not dead. In Saudi Arabia, they are not Christians. They are not dead. In China, they are not Christians. They are not dead. In Japan, they are not Christians. They are not dead. Africa should leave the African religion, the Jesus religion, the Muhammad religion, and let us go back to our roots. Go back to our Shango, our Ogun, our Opatala, our gods, our ancestors. We worship our ancestors. If we go back to that thing, and we're able to focus on that thing, and anytime any politician is coming to campaign, we'll tell you, go and swear on the shrine. No one is able to swear. I won't swear on the white mango.
Yeah, I think God forbid. I agree with him.
I would never swear on the white mango. So if you're listening to me today, first thing you need to do, change your mentality and be an African. No, you can marry white women, but your mentality to be African.
Yeah. You can marry white women, you can actually have partnership with white people. It's actually normal. But it's actually a very important thing for you guys to come out and speak. Because on Panther TV, we encourage people to able to pass on messages to other people that are watching. Perhaps we might not be heard right now, but we might be seeing one of
these. We'll see one day.
Yes. So one other important thing I wanted to ask, right? Like the leaders, right? What do you think the step the leaders should take if they might be watching you guys or maybe listening to you guys? What do you think the steps they might be taking for the development of a religion not to make sure Africa underdeveloped? Because a lot of followers, a lot of people have been so doomed in this situation.
No, you know, our leaders are, excuse me to say, very, very stupid. Like, this is not the leaders who will change the current situation in Africa. They cannot. Because they have been ruling for some time. If you look at the leaders, I'm not a politician, I'm not into politics, I've never voted before, I'm not into that at all. But if you look, someone wants to rule again and again and again in a country, and he can even fight for that, just for the leadership. We are not thinking of how to progress our nation, like as people in Africa. That is all. That is one point also killing us on that, you see? If I'm right, you will agree with me that is happening now as I talk to you. Some leaders will rig election just to rule again. But what is changing? They are not changing anything. They cannot change it. That is the honest truth. They cannot change the current situation in Africa. New Africans must rise up and change it. And move the old people somewhere and change the continent.
Okay. That's a very good intake, and I promise, I hope they will be able to watch it and listen to what we are saying. But my brother, you're from Nigeria. Yeah. You're from Nigeria, and we are seeing what is happening with Boko Haram and other things with religion. Do you think that this is the fight that's supposed to happen between Christian and Muslim?
No, you see, we're not supposed to have fights as Christians and Muslims. If we are going to have fights, we should have fights as Africans.